Lawson from CreativeGuitarStudio.com. Today we're going to talk all about one of the hardest things that there is to learning scales. But before that, I've got a warning for you. A lot of students get into scales in the wrong way. They jump into them too headstrong, learning way too much information too fast, too soon. They're biting off more than they can chew. You don't want to approach it like that. Another thing is there's a lot of concern a lot of times. You know, I get asked a lot, you know, which scale should I learn first? What's the best scale to start with? What scale will have me soloing the fastest? And you know, guys, really, there's a lot to this whole business of playing lead guitar, but the bottom line of effectively learning the scales will all come back to only a couple of things. Your ability to visualize and memorize the geometry involved with playing certain kinds of shapes on the neck, and also how well you can comprehend the tonality, in other words, the sound that a scale produces, so that you'll be able to become the most proficient at actually using the scale to create music. So let's begin by taking a close look at some key of A major scale patterns. We're gonna keep this very simple on the neck. We'll explore the shapes. We'll learn the reason behind why the scale is giving us a major sound. And then we'll take things a step further by learning how the major sound can produce other sounds called modes. The first thing that we're gonna go over is a full scale shape off of the fourth string, seventh fret A note. We're just going to walk up the scale tones A, B, C sharp, D, E, F sharp, G sharp, A. Now, that's the setup of a scale you typically get out of a book about scales for guitar practice or something. But what I wanted to bring about here is the first five tones. Those first five tones are really strong, and if you can learn to spot them for wherever you are on the neck, it'll give you some of the best soloing notes in the beginning. Also, there's some real big benefits too to outlining the major pentatonic. I'll highlight those notes in blue. Those are forming the pentatonic notes, the first, second, third, and fifth, to that fifth tone anyway. So those are very, very strong too, because we eliminate the half steps with pentatonics. And then another thing to remember is these shapes can move around. You know, I could jump this down an octave lower off sixth string fifth fret, and I could have the same shape. It's the exact same layout. It's exactly the same setup and interval structure and everything. So understand that these things move around, and the first five notes will really give you some of the strongest color, along with understanding how the pentatonic is set up, those the five-tone scale. All right, so I'm gonna leave you with that setup so far, and get you to start working on major and have a sense of understanding on the neck of the value of those first five tones. Major scale patterns have a group of notes from 1 to 5, and those tones work together to promote the major sound quality. And once that interval pattern is committed to memory, it can be extremely helpful to use for soloing on chord progressions that support the major key sound. Now, there is the major 7 step and the major 6 step, but the steps of 1 to 5 carry a lot of weight. They're very strong in the key. So what we're gonna do is take a look at an example progression in the key of A major that applies the first, third, and fourth chords. That's going to be an A major, C sharp minor, and D major chord. And they're going to form a nice solid backdrop for us for practicing the use of A major's first through fifth scale tones. Now remember, you could also add in the seventh and the sixth, but limit yourself a little bit in the very beginning to just using the first five. Okay, so here's the progression, and I'll play some soloing over it too.
Thank you.
have the mode idea that I want to go over, but I wanted to take a minute to let you know that if you need to learn more about the basics of guitar playing, like keys and harmony, arpeggios, as well as different bar chord shapes and other ideas, then I'm going to make you a great offer here. With any donation over $5 or any merchandise purchase from either the Teespring or my Zazzle store, you could pick yourself up one of these great t-shirts here. I'll send you a free copy of three of my most popular digital handouts. One's called Harmonized Arpeggio Drills. This is a great workout. It'll train you on developing your diatonic keys and the arpeggios that fit within them. Another one is I'm going to send you my bar chord and keys handout, which is really good. It includes a page showing all the key signatures along with a chord progression that applies bar chords as well. Plus, it doesn't stop there. You'll also get my notation pack. It has 8 pages of important guitar worksheets for notating anything related to music charts, guitar chord diagrams, or tab. And plus, I'm going to throw in a bonus item as well for you. Just send me an email off of the contact page at creativeguitarstudio.com to let me know about either your donation or your merchandise purchase, and I will email you those digital handouts within 24 hours. Now, the next thing to understand is every major scale can produce other scales called modes. A mode uses all of the same scale tones from the same key, but we get a different sound character because we begin and end the playing of the mode off of another note in the key, a note that is not the root of the major step for the key. So this means that if we were to select another tone from the notes of the A major scale, the one we've been working on, like for example, we'll go to the sixth note, the F sharp. If we selected that note, we could build a new sound when we play the A major scale off of the F sharp note. Now, the A major scale has the notes of A, B, C sharp, D, E, and F sharp and G sharp. But what we're going to do is focus on that F sharp note, and we're going to focus on it to build a new scale off of that using all of the same tones. Let's run through this in more detail. We'll zoom in on the neck and go through it right now. All right, so the first thing that we're going to do is take that F sharp note, and we're going to use it as a modal degree, a sixth degree of the A major scale, and we're going to play the full A major scale from F sharp to F sharp, creating its own scale of F sharp. So you can tell there I'm off the fourth fret note of the fourth string, and I've created a mode out of A major. It's the sixth degree mode. It's often referred to as Aeolian, so it does have its own name. More often than not, you've heard it called natural minor scale. But it's just the notes of the A major scale played off F sharp. We got F sharp, G sharp, A. There's a B, C sharp, D. There's an E, and then the F sharp up an octave. So that's the full 8 tones to the octave, but what I'd like you to focus on is the first 5. I'm going to also include the 6th because I want it to stay on the neck as a very smooth geometrical shape. You'll probably notice I did that as well with the A major. I wanted to include a very easy to look at geometrical pattern on the neck. So this is going to be what we're going to look at here. So I'm really focusing on the first 5 tones there. But you should also realize that up a half step, we do have that 6th tone of the scale too. All right, so that's staying in the 4th position there off 4th string. And if you wanted to, you could also look at that in terms of the minor pentatonic. I'll highlight those in blue again. So I'll give you the pentatonic tones. Remember, that eliminates the half steps. It gives you a little bit greater melodic control when you have the pentatonic in the mix. So that's called an F sharp minor pentatonic up to the 5th note. All right, so there's pentatonic available there too. And then remember, this is a geometrical pattern that's movable. So I could take it to other locations. I could play it from the 5th string, 9th fret. It's a little bit different color, it's a bit darker sound. I could even take it down an octave, play it off the low F sharp. You want it to sound really dark off the low tone second fret of the 6th string. So that's the fun of mixing up these ideas off of different steps of a major scale. You can go to really any of the steps, and there's a mode for every one of them. It doesn't matter if you're off the second degree or the third or the fourth or the fifth. All of these steps can generate other scale sounds, and this one happens to be minor. Every one of these steps is going to have a pentatonic that'll correlate to it. That's why the pentatonic is so valuable. Aside from it just eliminating the half steps out of the major and minor scales, it also gives you a really tight color to whatever happens to be going on modally. So what we're going to do next is start moving on to having some sounds that can be created around the chord of F sharp minor, and we'll get some sound connections to the minor scale mixed in with the chord changes coming up next for you. Knowing this information here about the scale of A major being able to be looked at in another way, we took it off of the note of F sharp, but you could really use any note of the A major scale to build a series of other scales off of any one of them. But you know, now that you understand a little bit about the minor scale, that F sharp minor scale we created, it's an easy to memorize minor scale shape on the neck. Looked at it, you tried it, I hope, and I think it'll help you to produce an interval-oriented note layout that's easy to visualize, regardless of the level of skill you have with playing melodic ideas that fit into the minor tonality. It's simple enough that you can memorize it quickly, you can move it around the neck for other locations, and I want to give you an example of all this being put into action next. So I've put together a short minor key chord progression based off of the F sharp minor scale, and I'll play you those chords right now, plus I'll add some scale phrasing so you can hear the soloing connection of the minor scale mixed in with the chord changes. So let's get on that right now. If you want to get a more detailed breakdown of all this information, including the diagrams for each idea I went over, then head down to my blogger page at creativeguitarstudio.blogspot.com. And if you found this video helpful, make sure you leave your comments and thumbs up below. Also, remember, if you're looking for a step-by-step guitar program that puts real tested methods into a proven guitar course, not just random YouTube videos, it's all available over at creativeguitarstudio.com. Plus, you'll want to make sure you're seeing all my guitar lessons here on YouTube, so go and turn on those notifications and subscribe to the channel. All right, guys, I'll be back here again real soon with another video. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you again next time. Bye for now. When it comes to online guitar lessons, there's no place better than creativeguitarstudio.com. General membership to the site is always free, and paid memberships to access our step-by-step beginner, intermediate, and advanced guitar programs are offered in reasonable monthly and annual packages. Skype lessons are also available if you need more specific instruction one-on-one to discuss the finer details of your guitar playing. Sign up today at creativeguitarstudio.com. I've got 25 years experience teaching guitar and have written a well-organized step-by-step guitar course. Head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com and sign up for a free membership today. Join the thousands of members worldwide who have already enrolled. There's no need to try learning the guitar on your own. Let me help you become the best guitar player that you can be.